Hey everyone, so in this series actually I'm gonna create rigging tools and stuff like that using Bifrost. So first of all, I started with this folder structure. Like this has a readme, a to-do list, and I have initialized Git. You can just search online how to set up GitHub or like your Python project, something like that. Then you'll know how to just set up basic Git installation and setup. Okay, and I use GitHub Desktop. So GitHub Desktop is a really nice application you can download. It simplifies Git a lot. Like you can use the command line and things like that, plus VS Code also has its Git this thing source control, and I use this so you can see the history and all everything, plus it synchronizes with your GitHub. So here it is, so you can use this. Okay, so let's just get right back to that. Here what we're gonna do is get to Git later, but I'll show you the folder structure for now. In this folder structure we have docs, source and test. So in document we'll store any type of document we need, or like if we create our documentation, if this project goes until that point or something like that. And this has third party scripts, since icons, if we create a UI needs icons and images, we'll keep that here. UI will be here in module. So in module we have everything, like whatever compounds, Bifrost compounds we'll create, we'll put them in here in Bifrost compounds. That is common scripts like importer. So what I do is I use this importer module. It has all these things which I want to import, and I just import this one main base component. This is like Python file which is fast code base. So if I just import this code base, let me just show you how you can do that. So for example, so I'll just import sys and import lib and like append that this thing e first code, then from source import first code base. When I do that, just look here, so and do that, it imports this sys time os recmds in PyMel, because I have those in the importer. So any module or anything I create here, I can just put this in here and always import just this. This will import everything, and I can even use this as fc or anything is equals to first code based on importer, or from import as fc I can use this as well, I think so. Yeah, now fc dot I have importer dot I can use pm dot. Yeah, I can easily use it like that. Okay, so that's the first thing, how I use the folder structure and stuff. So we have shown Git, we have shown how we use this. Okay, so first module or first script which I'm going to create is this thing, a parent constraint between two objects. We just need two objects, doesn't matter. Take one second. So let's check two locators here. Okay, locator two, locator one. So what we are gonna do is we're gonna create parent constraint between those these two. Let's name this source target, and we'll use Bifrost for this. So what we need is we need the world matrix of source and the offset between these two. This to this, I mean this vector. We need this vector as well. Okay. So let's do one thing. Let's take this here. And for this vector, like for this vector, what I'm going to do is I'm going to first multiply this to this, and this is A, B. So this will give me something like C, which will be far here. Then I will invert A and sub like multiply that inversion from here. So this will give me this vector. Okay. So let's create a Bifrost graph first. I think my Maya is gone. Where is that Maya? Yes. Create a graph. Let's name it. I'm going to convert this to a. How was that? Convert graph to DG node. Yes. Now it's a DG node. So parent constraint. Okay. Now what we will get in here is, so what we will do is we will do all this stuff from script and just pass a attribute, but for just for showing sake, I'm just duplicating both of these. I'm naming that as position. It's position. Just even hide these. Okay. Let's pass these three vectors, okay, in Bifrost graph. This. Okay. Three. Okay. This. This here. Let's add matrix. We need matrix. This here. Let's create three. Yep, we need three, and we need one output. So we will have source. Then we will have source position and target position probably. Yep, target position. And here we will have target offset. Okay, or just like target. So okay, so let's get this in. So world matrix of our source position, go in source position, world matrix of our target position, target position, world matrix of our source, into source. Okay, so now let's dive in here. What will we multiply? We will multiply source into inverse. First we will actually multiply target position, then we will multiply the source position inverse in here. So let me just show you how this looks. Okay, so if we see the source vector, this is this. Okay, so source position vector, that's the same. The target position, it looks like this. So just remove this. Then we multiply source into target. Second, wrong note. Matrix multiply. Sorry. For multiplying matrix, there is a different node. Source and what was that? Target position. Delete this. That, you see, it's like if you see, it is multiplied by this by this. Now when I multiply this with invert, this gives us proper position. Okay, so now what we are gonna do is you can actually look at like that also. I have one more. Yeah, this has a start and end over here. So starting is source and end is this. That gives us the proper vector. Rotates properly, looks good. So now we just need to push this here in the output, and this shape and this from here. Let's add our target. This is our target shape. We can directly use offset parent matrix, or we can decompose. Let's do the decompose first. So the translate scale shape target is at position. Let's take one temporary object as well. Let's take a cone probably. Put this here. Let's apply default parent constraint to the cone just to test if it's working fine or not. Constraint parent. Okay. Now let's rotate this, and we'll also switch on the LRS. I'm actually gonna shift one second. Let me shift it a little bit so it's easier to look. Shift this here. Now apply the parent constraint. Okay. Now let's test this. Working just fine. Moved it here. That works just fine. Group it, move it from here. Is it doing double transform or just moving fine? It's moving just fine. We're keeping the right distance. Yep. Always keeping the right distance, okay. It looks just fine. Let's zero this out for once. So we are able to keep our parent constraint with proper distance. Now we can also use offset parent matrix. I don't know why this line comes, but just let it be. So we are using decompose instead of using decompose matrix. Unnecessary nodes. Okay, so with this we can use offset parent matrix, but as you can see it will go double now right now because we have local values on the transform. Let's just zero that out. This works like a charm. Maya has done really nice adding offset parent matrix, making the zero groups redundant now, almost redundant. Yeah. So okay, so our parent constraint is done, but as you can see we have taken three inputs here, right? But these are just positions, these are not moving. These positions are just default offset between those two, right? So we actually don't need this. We just need one input which will have this already calculated, this offset between these two. Okay, so for that what we can do is we can calculate this in script. So let's just write a script for this.